Hello.
Hi, I'm Tommy.
Did you just appear out of my handkerchief?
Yes, I live here now.
Are you a genie?
I wish.
Do I get three wishes?
What's your first wish?
Yes, my first wish.
I love overlapping dialogue. Steve Morrow, the sound mixer, he has a way of miking everybody and mixing it in the moment so that we can use all of it.
Have you seen Lenny anyway?
Do you want me to fetch him?
Shooting those party scenes with everybody talking, that's something that's not normal on set.
Normally, you would just have the principal actors talking and everybody else would be just sort of faking it, and we would add in later a bunch of group and effects crowds and kind of cover all that. But, you know, a lot of times that feels kind of fake.
What that did is elevated everybody at the party to just feel real and also helped all the actors just stay in this party atmosphere.
Hello, how are you?
Charlie.
I'm all my hat.
In that way, you could create a sense of vibrancy, of activity, of excitement.
Pleasure to meet you. How are you? Are you having a good time?
And so the sound is putting you actually in that space.
And I think that when you can offer that to actors and to a director, it makes everybody just more excited about the scene, more involved in the scene.
He set the party up and we just had to go to it. It was a really fantastic way to work.
You know, it was something we played around with, and Bradley was like, yeah, like do more.
That was a huge advantage for us to be able to achieve that sort of realistic, sort of naturalistic way.
It just lends an authenticity to the movie that we were always striving for in the film.
It's a very, very subtle soundtrack, and so every sound is heard, and the specificity of each of those sounds was very important.
Bradley made it clear that there was a wind motif throughout this movie, and they're at Tanglewood the first time and they're sitting in the grass playing the guessing game.
20.
No. No.
The wind is very gentle and you're just in it with them and you feel the space.
It just adds a warmth and a closeness and a tactile quality.
So how long do we have to do this for?
Oh, we need to build up a very strong connection.
Then in other scenes, when he's on the balcony of the house and that big tree moves, we really play the wind there.
Sad, darling, and I don't know why.
The specific use of sounds can have an emotional impact on the scene.
Summer sang in me a little while, and sings in me no more.
It goes perfectly with what he's saying. When it kind of goes dark, and the sound is going dark, and it's not score telling you, you know,
how to feel.
How to feel. It's actually wind and birds.
If the summer doesn't sing in you, then nothing sings in you. And if nothing sings in you, then you can't make music.
We really wanted sound to be invisible and not getting in the way of the music, not getting in the way of the performances. You know, we were all just there to help Bradley with his vision.
When you're talking about a film that centers around music, it's important to capture that feeling. And Bradley's vision from the beginning was always to get it live. If it's on camera, he wants to record it live. And so the challenge is, how do you do that? So for Ely Cathedral, we had to really saturate all the instruments with as many microphones as you can, and then post-production can do their magic. They can clean it up, they can isolate certain tracks, and really make it all make sense.
And that scene I was so worried about, because we did do it live. That was the London Symphony Orchestra. It was recorded live. I had to conduct them. And I spent 6 years learning how to conduct 6 minutes and 21 seconds of music.
Massive amount of people involved in it. It's a delicate thing to make it so that you, as the audience, you focus on those things, you know, strings and brass and percussion, etc., and you feel the believability of the space that you're in.
So that was a process of a lot of planning, a lot of discussions, and on the day, everything came together and you get to hear the result.
The sound mix on this movie has a rhythm to it, just like the music has a rhythm to it. And you don't notice it, but you hear it and you feel it.